हेलो एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर महेश कुमार एंड टुडे माय लेक्चर ऑन टॉपिक एनल इनकॉन्टिनेंस और फीकल इनकॉन्टिनेंस। देर आर थ्री टर्म्स, एनल, इन एंड कॉन्टिनेंस। द एनल मींस पर्टेनिंग टू एनस, इन मींस नॉट, एंड कॉन्टिनेंस मींस टू स्टॉप, मींस लॉस ऑफ सेल्फ कंट्रोल, especially of urine, feces, semen. In context to anal continence, the lack of control over defecations. A similar term, incopresis, is also famous, which means in which condition a child resists having bowel movement causing impacted stool to collect in the colon and rectum and lead to leakage. This can be managed simply toilet training, plenty of fluid, fruits, vegetables and fibrous diet indication. Generally, the incopresis have no organic cause. The definition of anal incontinence is failure of the anal sphincter to prevent involuntary expulsion of gas, liquid or solids from the lower bowel or rectum. The incontinence have features: inability to hold feces or leakage of feces. It is a sign or as a symptoms, but not an independent diagnosis or independent disease. This is related with some diagnosed disease. Fecal incontinence sometimes refer to soiling. What factors maintaining the anal continence? The anal continence maintenance done in three aspects: anatomical aspect, mechanical components, and neuro-mediated voluntary and involuntary control. The pelvic floor anatomy have a specific role in managing the continence. The normal physiology is also supposed to be favorable to make continence in feces. Normal rectal and colonic pressure and activity and normal pelvic floor function is responsible for maintaining the continence in anal region. What are the types of anal incontinence? The anal incontinence have categorized in different way, like urge incontinence, true incontinence, full incontinence, temporary incontinence, easy after large dilatation, permanent incontinence. Basically, the two types, temporary incontinence and permanent incontinence, is famous. The temporary incontinence have no major difficulty. They are basically minor cases and develop after large dilatation procedures or some other conditions and managed easily with conservative management. The permanent incontinence have difficult in nature and not easy to cure in some conditions. What are the etiology? The etiology may be congenital anomalies, may be incopresis, traumatic injury at anal region after surgery, after childbirth, yeah, any wound formation at anal region, or iatrogenic after surgical intervention of the anorectal diseases. Descent like rectal prolapse or perineal descent. In such conditions, the seepage or soiling from the anal region also seen. Anorectal mass like prolapse pile mass. She is also responsible for causing incontinence of stool. The malignancy, the carcinomatous condition at the anorectal region, and after radiotherapy, the anal continence conditions also seen. The age factors like senility, old age, malnourished conditions, general debility of the patient, and chronic diseased persons have also problems of anal incontinence. The psychological factors and psychosis is also responsible in anal continence. the fecal impaction, the overflow incontinence by neglecting the natural urge of defecation, it also causes incontinence. The neurological causes are denervations like pudendal nerve injury, spinal nerve injury, spina bifida, meningomyosis, and spinal surgeries is also causes anal incontinence in many cases. What are the clinical features of anal incontinence? The uncontrolled passing of stool, leak out of feces unexpectedly through anus, and the features ranges from small stool or gas leakage to complete loss of control of stool. But the persons become embracing. The details about history of disease like IBS, irritable bowel syndrome, inflammatory bowel disease, diarrhea, prolapse pile mass, rectal prolapse, surgery at the anorectal region, malignancy condition at the anorectal region, and irradiation or radiotherapy at anorectal regions have features in anal incontinence. What are the differential diagnosis of the anal incontinence? The differential diagnosis is solely depend on the rectal discharge. The cardinal features in anal incontinence is rectal discharge, and from that features the other diseases may be excluded or differentiated. The differential diagnosis should be made with fistula in anus, rectal prolapse, IBS, irritable bowel syndrome, IBD, inflammatory bowel syndrome disease, and proctitis. These are the common conditions in which there is, or sometimes colitis. Maybe in this condition, the rectal discharge seen and they may be differentiated from each other. How to make the diagnosis? The diagnosis mainly done on the basis of clinical history and by rule out the existing causative factors. The per-rectal examination is sufficient to make the diagnosis, but in some conditions, anorectal manometry is required to measure the pressure in the anal region. The sigmoidoscopy and defecography make the diagnostic tools for diagnosing the anal incontinence. The defecography is important investigations in diagnosing the case. Management, how to manage a case of anal incontinence? In general, the anal incontinence is treatable and it depends on the cases and the causes of the anal incontinence. In minor cases, reassurance and exercise to increase the tone of anal sphincter, external anal sphincter and internal sphincter is done. In major cases or in permanent incontinence cases, surgical management is required. In this, they unite the divided sphincters, inter-sphincteric repair of puborectalis slings that was indicated. Plications of external sphincters advised, and make new anal sphincter with gracilis muscles is a type of surgical intervention in the management of permanent anal incontinence disease. The suturing of the torn sphincters, puborectalis muscle repair, plication of external sphincters, and encircling around anal canal by gracilis muscles or Marcellin sutures, and the electrical stimulation of the puborectalis muscles. These are the some surgical interventions which are generally in practice in cases of anal incontinence. Now, the specific therapy, the Sicca therapy. Sicca therapy is indicated in managing the anorectal anal incontinence. The Sika therapy is an innovative therapy for bowel incontinence. It is safe, effective, minimally invasive procedures, and it is a day care procedure and can be performed in OPD level in surgical unit. Aim is of this Sika therapy is to develop scarring and fibrosis of internal sphincters and adjacent tissue of the anorectal junction. Method: with the help of Sika device, a specific device known as Sika device, use of temperature control radio frequency energy. The temperature control radio frequency energy is used in Sika therapy to develop the scarring or fibrosis in the anal internal sphincters and adjacent tissue of the anorectal junction, so that the strength of the opening increases and the anal incontinence conditions can be controlled or managed. What precautions should be taken in anal incontinence cases? Simply, like, avoid spicy diet, junk food, clear the bowel, avoid alcohol, caffeine, about excess weight lifting are the factors which raising the intra-abdominal pressures. Sitz bath, 2 times hot sitz bath at the perirectal site. The matra basti, 10 ml oil perirectal HS to facilitate the passing of stool and flatus. Exercise is advised to strengthen the muscles of the muscles anal internal sphincters, external sphincters. In this, they tighten the sphincter muscles, hold as much as possible, and then relax. Repeat this cycle many times. With the help of this, the anal sphincters, external anal sphincters, and internal anal sphincters become strengthened and able to hold the anal openings and making the proper continence. Use pad of highest absorbency or absorbent pull up underwear. This absorbent pull up underwear is popular in patients having anal incontinence. In general, I hope you able to know about the anal incontinence. The points to be remembered in this condition is that the factors which making the anal continence is the rectum, internal anal sphincters, and internal anal sphincters. And the basic etiology behind the anal incontinence is the functional couch, sphincter weakness, and sensory loss. The functional factors like fecal impaction, dilated internal anal sphincters, diarrhea, psychological. And sphincter weakness is the sphincter muscle injury like pudendal nerve injury, central nervous system injury. And the sensory loss like afferent nerve injury and the conditions unable to detect rectal filling. These are the conditions which basically causes anal incontinence. The diarrhea, constipation, and sensory loss are the common causative factors in anal incontinence. Most of the cases are able to manage with the help of medications and sometimes the general surgical procedures required. Thank you for patience listening. Thank you so much.